Time is what a clock measures. So what allowed us to say before, now and after.
What is time? This very philosophical question has many answers. A very practical one is, time is what you measure with a clock. But what is a clock? Any process that repeats in the same way can be used as a clock. A good example is a pendulum. When there is no friction, the pendulum keeps swinging in the same pattern forever.
Time represents the flow of events. Even if for us it's an obvious concept, it's not so easy to describe it.
A pendulum can be used to measure the time that any other process takes, simply by comparing the number of swings to that other process. For example, our pendulum happens to have the exact same period as this heartbeat. And also the exact same period as this metronome. Actually, this is how we know time is a physical quantity, independent of the pendulum we choose to measure it with. Even without the pendulum, the heartbeat and the metronome have the same rate. Time is a property of nature, not of the pendulum.
My job is to measure time, or right now to build a clock that will allow us to measure time very precisely. The application of a very precise clock would be, for example, on navigation and telecommunication, better synchronization in networking. It's also interesting because it opens new physics, so to see changes in fundamental constants or observe gravitational waves.
So, pendulums are clocks. But what is the most accurate clock in the world? How does it work? And what can we do with it? Keep watching this series of videos and you'll find out.